If 50 years from now, somebody asked you, are you proud of the life you've lived? Are you proud of the life you've lived? What would be your answer?
I think I'm very proud of the life that I lived. I'm proud that I did not continue on the job which I hated. And I'm proud I did what I loved and I followed what I wanted. So yeah, I'm proud of the life that I've lived.
I always wanted to do something where if I was taken out of the equation, the work would not make sense. I think what I'm doing right now is just that. And I'm so happy to know that I'm making a difference in people's lives.
Yeah, I think one thing that I can say for sure is that the answer to that question will be absolute yes. I really, really, really genuinely enjoy every day of what I'm doing today. I think 50 years from now, if I'm asked that question, absolutely yes.
Those were answers from some of the guests on the Break School podcast. People who broke away from what they did not like doing to do what they love every day and earn a living through it. The Break School is a collection of conversations with such path breakers to understand how did they do it. I'm Sanjay Khandelwal, your friend and host for this podcast. I love enabling people to do what they love, and I do that every day through this podcast. To be very clear, my purpose is not to find ways to be uber rich. It doesn't excite me at all. The purpose is not to demonize corporates or to tell you it's a bad thing to have a job. I have a job myself to pay my daily bills at the moment. The purpose of the Break School is to enable you live a fulfilling life by finding something you love doing it every day, and eventually making a living out of it. Why do I think this matters? Because all of us on average spend 9 to 10 hours doing something that helps us earn a living. That's more than 60% of the time when you are awake. If you don't like what you're doing during those 9 to 10 hours, if you don't enjoy what you do for a living, if you don't love what you do every day, then just imagine you're going to spend 60% of your life doing what you don't like. There's a very simple way to know if you fall into this category. How do you react if somebody asks you about your work on a Sunday afternoon? If you jump down and start talking about your work with a lot of enthusiasm and excitement, and you can just go on for hours, then you're already going good. But if you smirk and say, please, let's not talk about work today. And sometime later, you feel really bad about the Sunday coming to an end, and you cringe about the coming Monday, then it's time you find something you love doing. Something you'd be excited to talk about, not just on Sunday afternoon, but even at the middle of the night. Of course, it's easier said than done. Even if you find something you love, you just can't quit what you're doing today. You'd naturally have a lot of questions before making the leap. Some of your questions could be, Did you quit your job sometime later to just start with YouTubing, or how did the transition begin? All right, so Rahat, what made you believe that this had potential? Was it just pure intuition, or did you have some kind of data, or was it the first client that you received that made you believe that, okay, this could actually move forward? I want to understand, how did you know you were getting better? Did you have a kind of feedback loop? Was someone watching the videos and giving you feedback, or were you just watching it and getting it better yourself? What kind of schedule or what kind of routine did you follow to manage both your job and podcasting? How did you plan your finances when you were transitioning towards taking this full time and while you were in the job? What kind of systems did you build to reduce time on things that you had to repeatedly do for podcasting? How do you make money? We will try to answer most of these questions on this podcast. In addition to speaking to these path breakers, we will also have conversations with experts from various domains such as personal finance, neuroscience, psychology, food and nutrition, and leadership, to pick specific skill sets necessary to survive when you're on your own. We'll release a new episode of the Break School podcast every Saturday night at 9 p.m. To make sure you don't miss out on any of the episodes, please subscribe to the Break School podcast on Apple Podcast, Spotify, Google Podcast, Stitcher, or Castbox. just go to any of these applications and type The Break School in the search bar. And when you find it, hit the subscribe button. You can also listen to The Break School podcast on our website, www.thebreakschool.com. If you like what I do, then please do leave us a review on The Break School website and Apple Podcasts so that others can find it very easily. And yes, if you'd like to ask any question to any guest on The Break School podcast, or if you'd like to write to me, I would love to hear from you. You can write to me at sanjay@thebreakschool.com, sanjay@thebreakschool.com. That's it from my side. I'll see you on 18th with our first episode. Until then, do what you love every day. If you don't know what you love doing, then start looking for it. Because remember, you will have to ask this question yourself. If 50 years from now, someone asked you, are you proud of the life you lived? Are you proud of the life you lived? What would be your answer?